we go. So you know where you are right now. Okay, perfect. I'd be totally remiss if I didn't keep and consistently say thank you very much to all of our sponsors today. Without them, you wouldn't have eaten, you wouldn't have had lights on, and the Wi-Fi would have been even slower because it would have been through my dial-up on my phone, which is Canadian, so that would have taken some time. You've heard a lot of things, you have a lot of stuff about ML and AI today, and if you go to this page in OpenShift and you want to learn about AI and ML, that's a great central jumping off point for everything we've had today. And all the productization of it, as well as how to get to some of the community stuff and operator hub and all other cool stuff. Oops, did I get the right one? Yes. I think I have the wrong slide deck. Well, we'll use this one. Yep, this is the one I wanted. I'm right. It all looks so familiar. So what I wanted to end on was how to keep connected to the community, how to find us, and how to continue these connections. And if we've noticed on all of the breaks today, they all got longer and longer, and I had to actually haul you back into the room half the time because you were having conversations. And that's exactly what I wanted to see happen today. I wanted you all to be jellyfish and to connect with each other without stinging each other, without losing track of conversation and time, because really it is truly all about connecting the dots. And those dots are human beings, those are people that have very interesting lives, very interesting thoughts, processes, and things that are gonna help you all in your collaborations and drive the innovation into your project. So as we look, mostly spend our time navel-gazing at the one project that we're working on, we really wanna see you start to open up your conversations and go across the communities and collaborate with other people, because everything we're doing within the cloud native foundation computing ecosystem and the OpenShift ecosystem, it all is connected. We're all interdependent on everybody else. And I'll just, I know a couple of people here got rooked into talking because they figured out a way to find you, and I'm using my very, I feel kind of guilty because it's not an AI tool. It'll be scary when these sets of tools are actually AI. It's just basic ELK stack networking things. But I really wanted to say, sort of like with the Databricks thing operator, if you don't believe that you're all connected, this is just a little way of how we're using these tools just now on GitHub data to figure out who the key people are working on, in this example, Jaeger, and how to connect them. So when I need someone to speak from the community, I can go find Greg or Jurassi or Julius really easily and drill down, find them, and bring them to the stage. So if there's a topic or something that you want to learn about, or if you're in a company, we can start to see all of the different pieces of these ecosystems that are important to you. So like Amadeus came to a conference, a gathering, and they introduced how, you know, their journey to OpenShift, but this follow-on conversation was really about Kafka, because that was the thing that they were most interested in. So we're starting to see the interconnectivity and the migration paths people have from one project to another, and how that's all that interplays there. So we're really very easily can prove that you're all interested in lots of things and that you're all interconnected. And now, how many IBMers are left in the room? Raise your hand. All right. So the complexity of my task just got astronomically larger with the recent, it's actually an acquisition, but it feels like a merger to me, because they have been so wonderful in terms of openly collaborating and reaching out. But that just brings in another 360,000 employees over to IBM that we have to keep track of and connect with. So the way that we're trying to help you guys do that is if you go to opendatahub.io and sign up for the mailing list, participate in the conversations there. If you are building an operator, come to operatorhub.io. If you're working in the CNCF, and you're building something that's part of there, go to the KubeCon, come to the gathering that's coming up on November 18th. We're gonna do this again, and it'll not be an ML or an AI specific one, it'll be a Kubernetes one, and there'll be some great people. We actually rented a boat, and we'll have a lot of operator stuff there too, not just ML and AI stuff. But if you have an operator, or if there's an operator on your wish list that you really wanna see in Operator Hub, reach out to us. All of these things are interconnected. Usually it ends up with an email in my inbox, but I can help you find and connect to the people that you need to meet with and connect with. This AI landscape diagram looks crazy, but give it 6 months, it's gonna be crazier. You know, it's gonna be even more highly populated. So staying connected and joining the community and being partaking of it, not just being an observer in the aquarium, but actually connecting and joining some of these forums and the SIGs is really an important piece that I can say, besides just the people you've met today. Please have an opportunity this Friday to come to the November 1st one. Peter Hack is gonna be talking about OpenTelemetry. Come sign up, you'll get an announcement and an invitation to come to them. And if you have something in that space that you wanna talk about, let me know. Let the chairs, who in this case are Juana Nockfor and Ryan King, know, and we will gladly give you the podium to pontificate and talk about it. Or even just show the alpha version of something you're doing and get feedback from the community, because that's the way this works, is we don't necessarily need you to be perfect. We need you to be open. Is much more important to us as well. So there's the machine learning SIG, and so you'll hear more from the Operator Hub. And overall, if you're interested in Kubernetes, if you're part of this ecosystem, there's probably no way anyone in this room is not part of this ecosystem. Please consider joining the OpenShift Commons. There, it's free, it's not, there's no pay-per-view, there's no foundation within it. It's an open community across the entire ecosystem. We'll be meeting again on November 18th, day zero of KubeCon. We'll be meeting again in London in January, I think on the 29th of January. We're gonna do it again at Red Hat Summit, because virtual briefings and all the other things we do, the Slack and that, is wonderful to staying connected over time. But it's this face-to-face connectivity to actually meet human beings and talk about ethics and talk about the future that really is gonna make the impactful difference in your conversations and the innovations that we drive into these products that we're all building and these projects that we're all leading. One other pitch, if you're coming to KubeCon, the UX design guys who came here today are gonna do a talk. Have another hands-on workshop. This time it's gonna be on multi-cluster management and GitOps. So if you really want, if you're an OpenShift user and you wanna have your say about this, this is the space to do it. So reach out and definitely take advantage of that. So today, really, it was an AI thing, but it was really about facial recognition. It was about you guys making some connections, and I hope you all did. I hope y'all will come and join us and the sponsors in the room behind us, have a beer, make some more connections, and avoid the traffic. Don't breathe in the smoke, stay safe, and hopefully have a wonderful Halloween, and keep in touch with us. Join the Commons, as I say, it's free and it's open, and it's what you make of it. So again, we know about what we learned about today, but what we don't know is what's coming down the path. And so let's discover some of those other 300,000 jellyfish, invite them to the party, and make them talk about what they're doing in this space. So thank you very much, and please, thank you to all the speakers and all the sponsors today. It's been a wonderful day, and I have learned a lot of new things. So thank you for sharing.